With the Wiener forklift that I got from my sponsor GearBest, another browser-controlled robot has entered my RoboStadium. Besides the radio-controlled forklift, I got a Raspberry Pi and a couple of more components from my sponsors to do the conversion. The USB camera that transmits live pictures to your browser is provided by the company ELP. Let's have a closer look at the forklift in original configuration first. In the package there is the forklift with the remote control, an USB charger, 3 plastic pallets as well as the forks and a crane add-on made of metal. The dimensions of the forklift are approximately 50x17x30cm, the roll cage is composed of metal, the body consists of quality plastics and the tires are made of rubber. The build quality is very good, there are no sharp edges and the chassis of the vehicle is really sturdy. You can insert the forks at the front and move them sidewards to adjust the width, same as with a real forklift. The crane can be added at the center of the lift mechanism. Four AA batteries that are not included in the package are needed for the remote control. The drive battery is placed in a box at the bottom of the forklift and it is composed of 6 nickel cadmium cells with a total voltage of 7.2 volts and a capacity of 400 mAh. A tiny screw locks the lid of the battery box. After turning on the remote control and the forklift, the fun starts. With the remote control you can command the vehicle into forward or reverse direction, as you can see only the front wheels are driven. The motor control is not proportional, but all or nothing. The steering is done via the rear wheels, either to the left or right. Same as with the drive control, the steering is all or nothing as well. As you can hear, the steering motor isn't powered off when the end position is reached. Furthermore, this motor is very loud. With two buttons you can lower or lift the fork. The motor doesn't stop turning when the top position is reached, you can hear the gears of the transmission skipping when keeping the motor powered. Same is for the bottom end position, you can hear the torture transmission as well when keeping the motor powered. You can activate a sound module through the remote control that imitates the sounds of a real forklift, more or less. First of all, the sound quality isn't overwhelming, secondly, the electric motors of the forklift are anything but quiet and finally, all that sounds jangle your nerves quickly. Four LEDs serve as headlight and indicators. With the 3 pallets and the crane add-on you can play around and become a professional forklift driver quickly. It is really great fun to drive goods from A to B on the pallets. With the all or nothing control you need some practice to pick up the pallets. The Wiener forklift is a radio-controlled vehicle that is fun to drive and a great learning experience. The machine can lift high loads, here it picks up 1.5 kg. If the load becomes too high, the transmission of the lift mechanism reminds you that you should really stop overstraining the forklift. Experienced forklift drivers know about the dangers of picking up too high loads. So stay clearly below 1 kg of load to avoid damage of your machine. The batteries are good for approximately 20 minutes of driving fun. The USB charger needs almost 3 hours to recharge the batteries, here I'm using my laptop as power source. In order to give you a hand on my forklift, I will now start to convert the vehicle into a browser-controlled robot. I'm starting with a close inspection of the transmission of the lift mechanism. The teeth of the gear start skipping whenever the load is too high, thus I will add end switches to protect the mechanism from damage. The steering motor doesn't stop at the end position as well, however there is a centrifugal clutch that protects this motor from damage. The electronics is on a tiny board that is populated with chips on both sides. I will control the edge bridges on the board with a Raspberry Pi. If you can't find a datasheet, you can start to guess and gauge what pin belongs to what function. Turn the forklift off. Now you can find the output pins by switching your multimeter to continuity and put one probe on a motor terminal while testing the pins with a second probe. You can hear that the motor of the lift is connected to pin 5 and 8 of the tiny chip. The motor terminals of the drive are hidden, which is why I'm touching the connector on the board with one probe. This motor is connected to pins 9, 12, 13 and 16 of the large chip, which is obviously a double edge bridge with the output switched in parallel. Now we know which edge bridge belongs to what motor. Now turn on the forklift and dial your multimeter to voltage detection with the black probe being connected to ground on the board, labeled with B-. The battery voltage is on pins 8 and 4 of the large chip and pin 4 of the tiny chip. You can identify the two input pins of each motor by activating the motors with the remote control. There is no voltage on the input pins while the motor is disabled. In forward direction there is a reading on one input pin, while there is a voltage reading at the second input pin of the edge bridge in reverse direction. We can identify pins 2, 3, 6 and 7 as inputs of the large chip. And pin 2 and 3 at the tiny chip. The edge bridge for the steering motor is at the bottom side of the board and you can find the pin layout in the same way. After identifying the input pins, you must remove the microcontroller of the radio control or else this device would work against the Raspberry Pi and so cause damage. I was using a Dremel to cut the pins off. After removing the chip you must check that none of the paths were shortened. Now cables are soldered to the input pins of the edge bridges in order to connect them to the Raspberry Pi. Especially the tiny chip at the bottom side was tricky to solder and you must avoid to bridge pins during that step. Check that out with your multimeter dialed to continuity. Some hot glue on the cables keeps mechanical load away from the solder points. Soldering is more easy on the top side since the pins are larger at those chips. 1 kiloohm resistors under the shrinking tubes prevent your Raspberry Pi and the board from damage in case something went wrong during soldering. The mount for the Raspberry Pi and a couple of more parts are made with a 3D printer. Even with only 5 volts of input voltage, all motors are running with sufficient power and so the low input voltage is better. First of all, the motors run with lower speed, which reduces output noise and wear on the mechanics, and secondly, there is no need for a voltage converter to drive the Raspberry Pi. More than 5 volts would destroy your Pi immediately, so don't use the converted forklift with the drive battery, at least not without a voltage converter. I got the USB camera I'm using for this robot from the company ELP. The great thing with this camera is that it has a variable lens. With 2 rings you can adjust the focal length as well as the zoom factor. The focusing range goes from 2.8 to 12 mm. The physical resolution of the sensor chip is 1280x960 pixels and the image quality is outstanding for an USB camera, I definitely like this device. With this camera you can explore my RoboStadium better than ever. I have printed a special mount with integrated LEDs for the camera, so that the lens can be adjusted remotely through 2 servos. 10 LEDs in total can be switched in 2 groups. There are gears on the lens as well as on the servos to operate the mechanics remotely, so that you can switch between a wide angle and a teleview. With the third servo you can tilt the camera. With the lift mechanism you can move the camera up and down, as mentioned before, there are end switches at the top and bottom. Besides the lower end switch you can see an infrared interface that can be used to control special modules in my RoboStadium. Electric power runs through 2 cables, so that you can drive this robot 24 hours a day and 7 days a week. There is an anti-twist mechanism on top of the forklift. The final step of the conversion is to remount the housing on the chassis. You can control my forklift from any place on this planet with internet access, here I'm using a smartphone. On my pages you can get the build instruction and drive this rover for free, there is no need for registration, simply go to the page and have fun. If you'd like to support me in running my robots, you can click on the donate button on my pages, many thanks to all existing backers. Thanks for watching and I'll be back.